Whitlock, should the Cavs be bothered by it?
Yeah, actually, you know, LeBron says some great things, then some things I disagree with. I don't think this is the right thing to be saying at this time. Let's just go back to February when there was a rumor about LeBron James and the Golden State Warriors. Listen to what LeBron said just a month ago about the rumors about him and the Golden State Warriors.
Well, please, for the rest of the season, don't ask me about nothing else, no other team, unless we're competing against them the next night, or you want to ask me about a highlight that happened the night before. Don't ask me about being on a team, on another team, because it's unfair to my teammates here, my 14 teammates that we come and work hard for, you know, the coaching staff and this fan base. Nice.
So here he is just 3 weeks ago, don't talk about this. To me, is an indication, has he given up on his new team already? And now that he's given up, it's okay to talk about other cities, Philadelphia, Golden State, whatever, just 2 or 3 weeks ago. Hell, and it's still February, our shortest month, but it's still February. He was saying, don't bring this up to me.
There you go, finding an old clip to ruin my argument. That's pretty good, I gotta be honest with you. Oh, I will say this, he's a really smart guy. I don't think he's gonna be swayed by billboards. LeBron's a real smart guy. But that's pretty good evidence. That was forensic files right there.
He's given up on his
current team. I'm not gonna lie.
I think he should be flattered. You know, if anytime you wanted in any job.
Of course.
How should his Cavaliers teammates feel?
Well, I don't think they should be worried. Because this is why I say that. You have a better life and you are happier when you worry about the things you can't control. Mm. They can't control if LeBron gonna be there or not. Don't even worry about it. You can't do nothing about it. If they wanna put billboards around the whole United States, come play on my team, so what? You have no control. Worry about the team you got now. You can't control where he's going to be there or not anyway.
Fellas, you got to understand, we live in a different day and age of transparency, right, where players can speak out. Players have voices. You can be yourself.
Was he speaking out 3 weeks ago?
He was, and he made a choice. He made a choice to make a statement for his team going into the trade deadline in amidst chaos. That chaos has died down now, so he can speak out and he can be himself. You could say this before. You didn't see Jordan go out and do this. You didn't see Kobe. You didn't see Magic. Those guys didn't speak about other teams. But now we have the freedom to be ourselves, in which it's not always wrong. You're just getting what LeBron is really thinking. And today and age of the day, age of Twitter, Instagram, Facebook, all this.
If you were on the Cavaliers team, how would you feel about him?
I would say he's being upfront, and I would know darn well that there's a realistic chance that LeBron could leave, and he's being upfront. Do I want to hear about that now? Not necessarily, but there's no way I'll blow it out of proportion.
For years and years, all these pro athletes get traded and have no control.
Shaq got traded.
Mm. Okay. But now that a player, an NBA player, is like, yeah, man, I'm kind of maybe initiating the trade. We don't like it. LeBron James can talk about moving. By the way, the GMs.
Here's what I don't like about it, Colin. I would not be giving up on this current collection of Cavaliers players. It's too early. Keep a single focus, making the most of this situation. Because again, it's like, control what you can control today.
Okay, let me ask you.
He ain't going nowhere today.
Right. Whenever you see in newspapers or blogs stories about trades, do you know how those get there? General managers leaking them. Mm.
You know,
so why can GMs talk about that?
The trade deadline's passed, Colin. The only thing he can accomplish the rest of this year is to win with this group of players.
Or lose with this group of players.
So why not focus on that?
I think that comment means he's not focusing. He was asked a question in a presser.
3 weeks ago, he was all in and don't bring up nothing about any other team unless we're playing them. It wouldn't be, his words, wouldn't be fair to these teammates. That's what he said then.
Yeah, but those guys are all out of town now.
And so now this new group, we can be unfair to them. He ain't got to be all in with them.
It was a pretty good case by you. You brought some old tape in, and so you feel good about yourself.
Do we have tape of Jordan ever doing this?
Yeah,
bailing on the team?
To Ryan's point, it's a different
world.
We
don't have a tape of it. We don't have tape of Jordan bailing on the
team. If you did that, it was disloyal. We live in a new world where players have smartened up and have power now.
We know LeBron's, he doesn't have to be all in. He's not all in, all right? It is safe to say, if they don't win it, nobody's going to lose their mind if the Cavaliers don't win a championship this year.
By the way, his contract's like a year. He tells you with his contract, I'm not all in. He's on. LeBron's totally honest. make my team better or
so
I'm
this
leaving.
This is a good thing. He's not all in. He's given up. He's conceded the title, Golden State. This is a positive. I mean,
I would argue, is he not the guy that's performed, fellas?
Yes.
He's performed amongst, we could say, the nonsense. Our generation says it's not, shut up and go play basketball. Well, LeBron's, I'm more than an athlete. I'm speaking out, and he's delivered.
Exactly.
We've seen LeBron raise a white flag before. Everybody, the first time he was in Cleveland, and they got in that Boston series, and he raised a white flag. Y'all want to see that again and keep comparing him to Jordan? Not going to happen.
Whitlock, should NBA stars stop complaining about officials?
For now, they should, and they should take it up during the offseason. I think they have a legitimate complaint. The league is refereed differently. I don't think it favors the jump shooter. And so LeBron has led this whining, and it doesn't surprise me that Paul George has followed suit.
I think this is ridiculous. So here are the guys that lead the NBA in free throws a game. James Harden, guard. Giannis, forward. Boogie Cousins, center. The guys that get to the line earn it. You want to know why Westbrook leads the league in drives, but Harden gets to the free throw line? Because Westbrook's blowing by people. And he's not getting fouled as much. Harden, in his herky-jerky stop-and-go style, is constantly creating contact. Two guys in my life have lived at the free throw line. Karl Malone and James Harden. They deserve it. Mailman wasn't the most vertical guy. Harden's not the fastest guy. If you look at who leads the league, it's guys that initiate contact, often have a style that's conducive to locking up. Harden doesn't blow by anybody.
He don't blow by anybody, but what Russ and LeBron don't do, like I said the other day, when Russ, LeBron, Boogie Cousins, guys like that, yes. Paul George complain about calls, you got to listen to them. They blow by people, but they still get fouled. They go to the rim just like everybody else. They're better than everybody else. You expect them to make the shots, but they still get fouled. These guys attack at a high rate. They might not get fouled. They might not get the calls because the referees expect them to make the shots most of the time, but they get fouled. But when they talk about calls, I got to listen to these guys because these are the guys that attack the rim the most.
The problem as players that we have with refs is not that they call a foul here, miss a foul there. It's consistency. I want to know that a foul is a foul night in and night out. You're in a lose-lose as a player. I compare a referee to a policeman. We need you. You make what we do safe. You officiate the game. We didn't like the replacement ref stack. We didn't. But you also have to understand it's a lose-lose because I'm not allowed to lose my temper with a policeman, with a referee. If you want to kick me out the game, you have authority to do so. You never make a mistake. As a policeman, as a referee, you really don't make mistakes. It's rare stack that you'll see a referee come over, I missed that one stack, right. My fault. And all we want is communication. When one night I can communicate to you and say, hey, you missed that foul, I thought I got fouled there, this is okay, I'll be better, hands off, we're good. And the next night I get told to shut up, play my role, I can't talk to you. That's the problem with players. We just want consistency.
That's a legitimate complaint because there are officials who are really rigid. And then there are guys that are a little more joyful. To your point, I've seen it with umpires through the years. There are some umpires that favor pitchers and some that favor hitters.
Refereeing a bunch of multimillionaires is hard.
Yep.
Because, again, when you're a multimillionaire, you got an ego. And you take on, like, a godlike complex a little bit. And you think you can do no wrong as well. And so I have some sympathy for the referees. The NBA has exploded. You know, you got sixth and seventh men making millions of dollars, and they all want to be ref like LeBron. And so all that chirping sounds the same to them. It don't sound any different when LeBron's chirping or the seventh man for the Memphis Grizzlies chirping. All the ref knows is like, damn.
But, Jay, how do you handle that, though? How do you handle that?
It's tough. Okay. They're humans.
I got
it's
somebody. Tough. Dick Bavetta. Dick Bavetta was 100 years old. Probably messed up more calls than you can imagine. You know the simple thing that Dick had? Respect for each and every man. And he made a call.
Different
you
era.
Listened.
Different era.
Why, though?
It's a different era. Because, one, Dick Bavetta's not reffing these current players. Dick Bavetta was reffing an older generation of players or a different generation of players. We got to move. I'm sorry.